Good day to all, and welcome back to the third and final installment of the Test and Measurement series. For those of you that missed the first two parts, just navigate your way to our website or visit our YouTube page. In today's presentation, you will discover the various capabilities of a few MathHooks tools that can be used to help you deploy all your algorithms. I will start by giving you a short introduction and then move on to six key toolboxes that can be used for test and measurement. The MATLAB environment for analysis provides the tools you need to acquire data and automate tasks. Within MATLAB and Simulink, you can control and acquire data from plug-in data acquisition boards, test instruments, web cameras and frame grabbers, as well as send and receive messages over CAN buses. Once you acquire data, you can interactively explore it and perform live visualization and data analysis. You can then build test systems, verify designs and concepts, and automate repetitive tasks. You can also deploy test applications built in MATLAB onto other computers. Typically, there are three stages to follow when it comes to test and measurement: communicating with hardware and instruments, analyzing your test data, and automating tests and building test applications. In this webinar, part 3, we will be focusing on the third stage, which is automating tests and building test applications. Let's move on to the first toolbox, which is the MATLAB compiler. So you need a toolbox that will allow you to build standalone applications from MATLAB. Then MATLAB Compiler is the toolbox you need. MATLAB Compiler lets you share MATLAB programs as standalone applications. You can also create Microsoft Excel add-ins and integrate them into Excel spreadsheets. When used along with MATLAB Compiler SDK, which is the next toolbox of interest, you can package MATLAB programs into software components for integration with other programming languages. All applications created with MATLAB Compiler use the MATLAB runtime, which enables royalty-free deployment to users who do not need MATLAB. You can package the runtime with the application or have your users download it during installation. MATLAB Compiler supports the full MATLAB language, including objects, most MATLAB toolboxes, and user-developed user interfaces. Whether you are sharing MATLAB programs internally with decision-makers and colleagues, or externally with clients and customers, MATLAB Compiler provides a convenient way to package MATLAB programs for distribution to end users who do not need MATLAB. Let's jump into the first of the four key features that I will be discussing. So I thought I would change things up a bit this time and share with you four user stories of companies that use MATLAB Compiler to speed up calculations, increase accuracy of results, and automate and accelerate tasks. First up, we have A2A, who developed a comprehensive risk management solution for energy markets. A2A used MATLAB Compiler to deploy standalone applications that analysts can use as a dashboard for visualizing results, managing risk, and recording contract information. Beth Israel Deaconess Medical Center improves MRI accuracy. Using toolboxes that were mentioned in previous two webinars, they mentioned to reduce programming time, achieve faster, more informative MR scans, and gain the ability to experiment with new approaches. 3 or 4 months of development time was saved, analysis accuracy was increased, and validation times reduced by an average of 40 to 50%. Bosch managed to achieve this using MATLAB, combined with the signal processing toolbox and MATLAB compiler, to create a standalone version of Envalizer, an internal tool that can be used by test engineers who do not have MATLAB installed. And lastly, this company used the toolbox from each of the webinars previously mentioned toolboxes. MATLAB and data acquisition, stats and machine learning, and signal processing, together with MATLAB Compiler. Ford deployed their sound quality metrics to different third-party analysis systems using a single version of the MATLAB source code. Sharing MATLAB programs with other MATLAB users as standalone applications can be done by directly giving them your MATLAB programs or apps. The image displayed on the slide is a solar analysis application created in MATLAB and packaged for sharing using MATLAB Compiler. MATLAB Compiler encrypts your MATLAB programs to protect your intellectual property, so your source code remains hidden from end users of your applications. Let's wrap the section up with two more features. Sharing MATLAB programs with Excel users is done by creating Microsoft Excel add-ins and integrating them into Excel spreadsheets. These add-ins let you perform analysis and simulations within Excel that include MATLAB math, graphics, and user interfaces developed in MATLAB. You can share it with those who may not otherwise need to use MATLAB, royalty-free. And lastly, there are apps for packaging your MATLAB programs interactively. Above standalone applications, Excel add-ins, and Hadoop libraries, the apps enable you to customize the installer of your application with information such as author, splash screen, and version number, automatically identify and select files that are dependent on your main MATLAB program for packaging, and choose whether to package additional data or help files with your final application. So let's move on to the second toolbox, which is the MATLAB Compiler SDK. By adding only three letters to the previous toolbox name, it extends the functionality drastically by allowing you to build software components from MATLAB programs. This toolbox lets you build C and C++ shared libraries, Microsoft.NET assemblies, Java classes, and Python packages from MATLAB programs. These components can be integrated with custom applications and then deployed to desktop, web, and enterprise systems. MATLAB Compiler SDK includes a development version of MATLAB Production Server for testing and debugging application code and Excel add-ins before deploying them to web applications and enterprise systems. Once again, there is emphasis on the fact that apps created can be shared royalty-free. These applications use the MATLAB runtime, a set of shared libraries that enables the execution of compiled MATLAB applications or components. The Compiler SDK also has three features worth mentioning, and the first one is choosing a language. For developers who want to integrate MATLAB-based programs into their own custom applications, Compiler SDK offers a comprehensive toolkit for working with applications written in C, C++, .NET, Java, and Python. When creating apps with Compiler SDK, you can follow the same basic process regardless of programming language. You also get language-specific features to help software developers integrate MATLAB-based components with the language best suited to their needs. Compiler SDK provides many features for applications written in the four languages mentioned. I would recommend that you visit the MathWorks website or read the documentation to find out more about the amazing features available. Skipping right into the second feature, but still relevant to deployment, is a range of platforms to choose from. Compiler SDK lets you deploy MATLAB-based applications to a wide range of platforms, from standalone desktop applications for individual users, all the way to large-scale web and enterprise systems. You can select your preferred platform based on implementation effort, maintainability, programming languages, and your organization's preferences. For web and enterprise systems, MATLAB Compiler SDK lets you choose your preferred method for implementing an application server, either developing a custom infrastructure or taking advantage of MATLAB Production Server for secure and scalable deployment. In both cases, the workflow is similar, but I will only cover the custom infrastructure development since the next toolbox discussed will be on the MPS, which is the MATLAB Production Server. For developers who prefer to create their own infrastructure, components generated with this toolbox integrate with standard technologies. There is a large list, and you can see most of them on the screen, that can be used for scalability. For applications that need to handle large numbers of concurrent requests, you can create a middle layer of RMI servers between the application server and the compiled MATLAB code. Compiler SDK also allows you to create components and libraries that can be integrated with a wide range of languages used within your organization. You can call MATLAB from another language or call libraries written in other languages from MATLAB. You can easily generate C and C++ code if you have MATLAB Coder and package MATLAB programs as software components. This does not stop you from creating hybrid systems if many users wish to combine more than one approach. Just before we move on to the next toolbox, and I have mentioned it a few times in the presentation, I wanted to share this image with you, a very high-level overview explaining how the toolboxes are interlinked and what I spoke about in the previous few slides. So the next toolbox up is the MATLAB Production Server. This powerful toolbox allows you to integrate MATLAB analytics into web, database, and enterprise applications. The MATLAB Production Server lets you incorporate custom analytics into web, database, and production enterprise applications running on dedicated servers or a cloud. You can create algorithms in MATLAB, package them using Compiler SDK, and then deploy them to MPS without recording or creating custom infrastructure. Algorithms developed in different versions of MATLAB can be incorporated into your application because it manages multiple runtime versions simultaneously. And lastly, the server runs on multiprocessor and multi-core computers, providing low latency processing of concurrent work requests. It almost feels like deja vu when I say there are three key features that are worth mentioning. And first up, we have production deployment of MATLAB programs. MPS is a runtime framework for integrating MATLAB analytics into enterprise applications, and it manages the running of different MATLAB analytics. There are three groups involved in rolling out the algorithm successfully. Algorithm developers, I'm sure you can guess what they do. Then there are the application developers who integrate the client libraries into their enterprise applications. The libraries support previously mentioned environments such as Java, Python, and .NET, and are accessed using the RESTful JSON interface in MPS. And finally, the IT system admins, who manage the deployment of MATLAB analytics within a production environment using a web management dashboard. If you have a look at the image on the right, which represents the workflow for production deployment, you can see that it enables the rapid development of analytics and the deployment with enterprise applications. The second key feature is the integration with enterprise applications. The MPS RESTful API enables you to evaluate MATLAB functions on remote servers using the JSON representation of MATLAB data types. Looking at the image on the left of the screen, you can see the integration of MATLAB Production Server with enterprise applications. System architects centralize the deployment of analytics to service a diverse set of applications. These interfaces let system architects and application developers incorporate MATLAB analytics into a wide assortment of web servers, databases, desktop applications, and other enterprise applications. The web interface shown on the right lets IT administrators manage deployed MATLAB applications and monitor performance. MPS is equipped with a web-based management dashboard that enables an IT admin to configure and control deployed MATLAB applications from a single interface. The management dashboard gives visibility into the system resources consumed by MATLAB production server instances and the real-time request throughput performance. Client libraries provide mechanisms to make connections and manage data transfer and calculation requests between the app and MP, allowing application developers to focus on the applications. The example shown on the screen is a MATLAB function and the .NET code that calls the function. Using native data types simplifies the integration of numerical analytics with enterprise applications. And I'm sure that everyone wants to know about performance optimization and scalability. The MPS handles large numbers of concurrent worker requests to run MATLAB analytics by taking advantage of the multi-core and multi-processor servers. In order to provide additional capacity and redundancy, you can deploy a MATLAB production server on multiple server nodes. In order to optimize performance, workers are allocated across available processing cores within a computer. System admins can configure the worker pool to optimize the number of active workers versus desired response time. MATLAB programs are run concurrently using these pool of workers. Workers are also kept on standby to reduce latency response if there are no requests. Any free worker in a pool can be enabled to service a request because MPS uses a stateless architecture, allowing for more requests to be serviced and optimizing response time. If a load balancer is used within your application or as an external device, clients' requests can be directed to any MPS in a cluster, which creates an architecture that is resilient to failures. Now moving on to the fourth toolbox, which is the OPC toolbox. So I'm very excited to talk about this toolbox because it was developed here in South Africa at Optinum Solutions. The OPC toolbox provides access to live and historical OPC data directly from MATLAB and Simulink. You can read, write, and log OPC data from devices such as distributed control systems, supervisory control and data acquisition systems, and programmable logic controllers. The OPC toolbox lets you work with data from live servers and data historians that conform to the OPC data access standard, the OPC historical data access standard, and the OPC unified architecture standard. The product includes Simulink blocks that let you model online supervisory control and perform hardware-in-the-loop controller testing. Finally, some change with six key features to discuss. They are short and to the point, but it gets the message across. There are three ways to access live data from the OPC Data Access Server. You can execute all OPC Toolbox functions directly from the MATLAB command line or incorporate them into your own MATLAB applications. You can use the OPC Client app to rapidly connect to OPC DA servers, to create and configure OPC Toolbox objects, and to read, write, and log data. And thirdly, use the Simulink blocks from the OPC Toolbox to read and write data to and from an OPC DA server while simulating a system. The Simulink model was created using Simulink blocks from the OPC Toolbox. Three blocks let you communicate with the OPC data directly to and from Simulink and your process system. Next up, we have the OPC Data Access object. You obviously want to manage your connections to OPC servers and collections of server items. So this toolbox employs an intuitive hierarchical object structure to help you. You create an OPC Data Access Client object to connect to an OPC server, which lets you browse the server namespace and retrieve properties. The toolbox also lets you configure and control all client, group, and item objects by modifying their properties. In Simulink, the toolbox uses a configuration block to specify the OPC Data Access clients. The config block can also be used to define the toolbox's behavior if the simulation runs more slowly than the system clock. Reading and writing to individual item objects or all the items can occur either synchronously, which implies that MATLAB execution is blocked until the operation is complete, or asynchronously, which implies that MATLAB can continue processing while the operation is in progress. The same can be done in Simulink using OPC read and OPC write blocks. The blocks contain a client manager that lets you specify and manage the OPC DA server, select items, and define block sample times. So the question is, do you have tons of raw data that you need to access from historical data access servers? You can browse a server namespace and retrieve fully qualified IDs of each item when you create an OPC HAD client object in MATLAB. The IDs allow you to request the historical data from the server. Some of the read operations that are supported are shown on the screen. Data is retrieved into an OPC HDA data objects, which allow you to visualize and pre-process the historical data for further analysis in the MATLAB environment. Pre-processing operations include resampling, data conversion, and data display functions. Creating an OPC UA client object is just as simple as the previous method used for HDA. The toolbox provides functions that enable you to browse and search the nodes in the server namespace to determine available data nodes. You can receive the value, timestamp, and an estimate of the quality of data from current node or node arrays. And lastly, you can combine the HDA and UA into one, allowing you to read historical data from the nodes on the UA server. The browse namespace graphical utility function allows you to find all the nodes available. All OPC UA historical data is stored in OPC UA data objects, which contain datetime objects to represent the timestamp. You can then easily visualize and process the data for further analysis in the MATLAB environment. Right, that's four toolboxes done and just two more to go. So the fifth toolbox I'll be talking about is the spreadsheet link for Microsoft Excel. Those Excel lovers users out there who still like using MATLAB but love Excel more should definitely get this toolbox. You can use MATLAB from Excel, which I think is pretty awesome. A very basic and affordable toolbox that allows you to connect Excel spreadsheets with MATLAB. With spreadsheet link software, you can exchange data between MATLAB and Excel taking advantage of the familiar Excel interface while accessing the computational speed and visualization capabilities of MATLAB. Spreadsheet Link features an Excel spreadsheet add-in that provides the functions that connect Excel and MATLAB. Excel provides a familiar interface that lets you edit and view your data. Spreadsheet Link lets you pass data and commands that operate on it to MATLAB. Microsoft Excel becomes an easy-to-use data storage and application development front-end for MATLAB. MATLAB functions can access and share the data in these variables, and you can call these same MATLAB functions from Excel formulas, macros, or Excel Visual Basic subroutines or functions. And that pretty much covers up the Spreadsheet Link toolbox. Now moving on to the last package that I would like to talk about, which is ThingSpeak. So IoT is growing substantially and everyone is talking about it. ThingSpeak is a MATLAB analytics platform service that allows you to aggregate, visualize, and analyze live data streams in a cloud. You can send data to ThingSpeak from your devices, create instant visualizations of live data, and send alerts using web services like Twitter and Twilio. With MATLAB Analytics inside ThingSpeak, you can write and execute MATLAB code to perform pre-processing, visualizations, and analysis. ThingSpeak enables engineers and scientists to prototype and build Internet of Things systems without setting up servers or developing web software. So Internet of Things, or IoT, is becoming a popular buzzword these days. It is an emerging trend that describes the situation with embedded devices and sensors all connected to edge nodes to upload sense data to cloud storage resources. Data can be used in some sort of software, for example, a platform like MATLAB and Simulink, to prototype algorithms to use that data that can eventually be run on both cloud computation resources and the edge nodes. With ThingSpeak, I'm going to talk about the capabilities rather than key features. There is a workflow to follow, and we start off with collecting data. There are sensors all around us, in our homes, smartphones, automobiles, city infrastructure, and industrial equipment. Sensors detect and measure information on all sorts of things like temperature, humidity, and pressure. ThingSpeak enables sensors, instruments, and websites to send data to the cloud, where it is stored in either a private or public channel. Storing data in the cloud provides easy access to your data. Using online analytical tools, you can explore and visualize data. You can discover relationships, patterns, and trends in data. ThingSpeak provides access to MATLAB to help you make sense of data. And lastly, you might want to trigger a reaction and act on the data that was analyzed. Acting on data could be something as simple as receiving a tweet when you are measuring temperature that needs to be regulated. You can even remotely control devices, such as battery-operated door locks, using the TalkBack app. ThingSpeak provides tools that enable device communication for all these actions and more. And that brings me to the end of my presentation, and I will end off with a call to action. I hope that you found all the parts of the series very useful. If you have any requests for specific features and toolboxes, please leave your comments below. If you wish to trial out the software, you can contact one of our business development consultants or sales reps by emailing sales@optinum.co.za. If you are already using the tools or have any technical questions, you can email our support queue at support@optinum.co.za. If you'd like to attend a training course to build your proficiency with using MATLAB and Simulink in your field, you can visit our website and navigate to the training course page. I hope everyone enjoyed the 3-part series webinar. Thanks for watching. Cheers.